Assalamualaikum Julie to everyone. We are the students of Government High School Baroo Kargil. Today we are going to tell about Kargil tourism. Kargil is one of the most important and most beautiful picnic spots in Jammu and Kashmir. It's situated on the bank of the river Suru, a main tributary of Indus River. This town is surrounded by mountains all over the side, and these mountains are covered with glaciers and snowfall. Unfortunately, many visitors get visited to only Leh district. They think Kargil as only a transient camp. There are many picnic spots in Kargil. They can be visited and enjoyed with nature.
Kargil Memorial is built by the Indian Army. The memorial has a large epitaph of the martyrs of the war. The locals played an important role in helping the army in the winning the war. This martyr was a portrait from Kargil during the war.
This is the Sardar Village in Kargil.
Here is a famous statue Lord Buddha, which is 42 km from Kargil. It is 10 meters tall, made of grey yellow rock. It is said that it was carved in 7th century. There were 4 statues in the world before, but they were destroyed. Now it is only one remain from that century.
We reached Damsna. It's a picnic spot. Damsna has a huge flat moist meadow surrounded by the river Suru, 61 km away from Kargil. It has a fine view of beautiful hills.
On the picnic spot, you can also visit this middle school Damsna. You can also see this typical school.
Talk about the special food of Ladakh, such as kulak. Kulak is made up of flour mixed into the gurguti and some ghee. And this is a mashed apricots mixed into water and milk. And this is very tasty and very delicious. And this is dry apricot. The apricot is very special food of Ladakh. The benefits of apricot include its ability to improve skin diseases, fever, digestion, and anemia. Apricots also help into improve heart health, strain muscles, and bone.
So it's locally called poli, and it's locally called gathur. It's made up of buckwheat and mixed water. It's made up of some curds and some hops.
This is locally called popot, this is stapkur, and this is skew. These fishes are made on special occasions like mamani, nindog yaspa, naros.
We find that the traditional dish is colorful and interesting. It seems the climate has affected the fashion.
Women wear a long advanced gown called sujaks, which reach below the mid-leg.
This dress is tied up with skirts. Our culture jewelry is like kumar, kau kansir, bemalapse, burga, sirup, nacha, and dubu.
We will talk about cultural festivals of Ladakh. Our cultural festivals are Mamani and Losar. Mamani is celebrated in winter. This festival showcases the cultural foods of Kargil. Every family brings a traditional dish to a common religious location and share the dishes with other members of their neighborhood.
Losar is one of our important cultural events. On this occasion, women go to their own homes and gather with their relatives.
We will talk about sport and dance. During 15th century, polo introduced it in Ladakh through our princes. The princess was from Balkistan. Polo game has acquired popularity of many years. It is still an essential part in Ladakhi culture today.
This game is played during the sports competition and also during the occasion of our local festivals, which include Naruz and Losar. Polo played in Ladakh is slightly different from one's played according to the international rules. It is played on barren land and it's much more intense than actual game. Kargil is known for our number of traditional sports activities and archery is one of them. Archery is played in Kargil and nearby village as entertainment.
Ladakh has a rich heritage of folk dance. The dance are elaborate, colorful and majestic, with mostly slow and gentle movements. A marriage or a fest is incomplete without our folk music and dance.
Now we will talk about languages.
There are different languages spoken in Kargil.
The official language of Kargil is Urdu, but there are quite few different languages speaking Kargil. The Balti, Purik are spoken. Languages are spoken by 78% of the population, while Shina and Dardi are spoken by 10% of the population in Kargil.
Kargil is often overlooked for the tourist-friendly land. Kargil is not only army, guns and bunkers. Kargil is natural beauty. Kargil is patriotism. Kargil is simplicity in people.